What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. You know, black men here in the black manosphere community, we understand that most of us grow up without a father in the home. I know one popular content creator that grew up with both his parents, which is shout out to Pocket Watching with JT, Real Account Reacts. Both of his parents, I believe, were successful entrepreneurs in the St. Louis area. And you do have some other people, too, like I have a female colleague, Erica Williams, who has both her parents. I have both my parents at a certain time. But there's so many guys who don't. And when we find out how to interact with women, it is usually the mothers who teach us, you know, kind of how to respect women, you know, how women are more, pretty much more above who you are. And you hear from your mom's own mouth how it's always your dad's fault or the man's fault. So you get conditioned to think like that. Very rarely do we believe that men condition their sons to be simps. But I want to have some proof today, because there are stepdaddy simps. There are guys who are married and are simps, and they influence their sons to be beta males just like them. I had a godfather who was a great man. I mean, we talk about like owning homes, just being a masculine man, being a builder. He only had a third grade education. He was from also the great state of Arkansas. But when it came to arguing my godmother, who I love so dearly, he would teach my dad, it's better to keep the peace. Don't argue with your wife. Let her say what she's going to say. Don't challenge what she has to say. Just do that. And that got my dad in a lot of trouble in my marriage, in his marriage to my mother for so many years. And it still affected him to this day. And this is what's happened in this response I'm dealing with today, guys. I got this from Brother Devin. A father posted on his Facebook about a 17-year-old son. And the son asked the father, could he go on a day date with the young lady from school? So the father is proud of his response. He says this, "Tay music, that's fine. I want you home absolutely no later than 7:30. Stop the show." That's understandable. It's a day date. You don't need to be out past that time. Because why? You don't want your sons out there, you know, having sex and all the other things, stuff like that. So that's perfectly okay with me. If I had a son, I would say the same thing. Day music! Public places only. No homes, no private rooms, no nakedness. Stop the show. I also agree. Even though when I was 17, booty clapping sounds, I was trying to get it in. I was thirsty. But I definitely understand that, right? Date music. Comport yourself as a gentleman, respectful, polite. Okay, dun, 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 sound effect. Okay, like, I agree with this also. Respectful, politeful as a man, not just to women, but to people in general. I think that's nothing wrong with that, all right? But I think here is when the simping starts. Date music, open doors, offer to pay for everything. Okay, so here's kind of where guys are going to start to have a problem with this. Open the doors, it's debatable, right? I know I open the doors, even in my apartment complex, I see a lady come in, I open the door for her. That's just, you know, me, and again, how I raised. Now, obviously, we are in the level of feminism where women can open the doors for themselves, but it's up to each individual guy to do that. Offer to pay for everything. Well, you are a young man. If you asked her on a date, sure, you can do that. I don't have a problem with that. But then also at the same time, you know, some guys can say, well, why not be 50-50? I'll leave it up to you guys. Now, this is where it gets real bad. Date music! Listen way, way more than you speak. Stop the All right. Yeah, you want to do that because you want to see how much lies she going to tell you. Right, like she gonna tell you how all these dudes ain't nothing, all the dudes that she dealt with was broke, You know, they all broke her heart and all this. So it's good to listen more than you speak, because you get to find out all these lies and you get to see all these red flags. And you can't see those red flags if you're not talking, if you're talking too much. However, the father is not saying that. Listen way, way more than you speak. In other words, let her talk, because she's more important than you and you don't have anything to say. Here's where he says the problem. Dang music! She's the boss. You're simply honored she chose to spend time with your goofy ass. Stop the show. this is what a lot of guys kind of feel right now. Like, this is how I used to feel. I used to feel like, wow, the girl is attractive. I mean, she's here with me. Like, man, I'm lucky she could be doing anything else. Like, she's here with me, though. Like, I should just be amazed. Like, thank you, Jesus, she's here with me. Okay? But this is actually wrong. Okay? You're not honored because she chose to spend time with you, because she's not better than you. She should be equally honored that you're going out with her. Okay? And in most cases, when it comes to me, you should be honored I'm talking to you at all. All right? You should be honored about that. Because why? I carry myself as a man that has respect for himself. You're not better than me because you're pretty. And you're not better than me because you're a woman. And you're not better than me because of any of these things. All right? You're not. You're not better than me because of that. And I think when black men start to understand that, and men in general, that, hey, just because this woman is beautiful, that doesn't take away the years that you've been building yourself, the years you've been building your network, the years you've been building your skill sets. I mean, we have to be honest. Men build communities. Men build skills. Men build jobs. Men build places to protect women. And if you're a great man, that's something to be competing for in the world today. There are not many men out there who do that and have that access. So if you are a man that has the access, a woman should respect that also. Okay? Yes, it's cool to, you know, she's a good-looking woman, she's coming out with you. That's true. You know, it's very, very nice for a woman to do that. If she's good-looking or she's a nice person and she has something to offer, that's great. But no, there should be some equality here in this. And many feminists would have no problem with the father telling a son this. Okay? Your job, day music, your job is to be chivalrous, courteous, and kind while simultaneously being protective and strong. You're a man, but moreover, you're my son. Conduct yourself accordingly. See, this is how a lot of American men think, especially in the black community. Black young men get this the most, but they're not getting it from their father. They're getting it from his mother. But what has failed in most concepts in the manosphere is that a lot of men indoctrinate their sons with this garbage. And many of you guys have become like 25 and 30, and you're like, damn, well, how I used to feel when I was young, I was like all wrong. Like, wow, I should have found this red pill shit like a long time ago. This is why so many guys still watch me. They watch other guys because, you know, even you've been kind of blue-pilled into a world that's not reality. And what happens is you do all this stuff and the woman doesn't even like you because you don't stand up for yourself. You're just doing anything to be with her. So a woman is going to go and find a man wherever she can find one. And a man that's going to be a man and stand on his own principles, that's who that woman's going to go be. You're setting up this young boy to be eventually used and abused. I have no problem with being nice to women. I have no problem being given to women and building things or whatever for a woman that you think that's nice. I don't have no problem with that. I really don't. Okay, but once we get on the situation where we're dealing with this bullshit, I'm gonna have a problem with that. Okay, I'm gonna have a problem with that, and that's the situation that we're dealing with. Okay, that's the problem. You know, you're not better than me because you have a different sexual organ. I'm sorry. But guys, what do you think? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. I really appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe, hit the bell, check out the first comment at the top. And as you know, the buffoonery remains at an all-time high. I'm out.